Hi guys, this is tabletnews.com and I'm here with a tablet called AllView Speed City. It's a Romanian brand tablet. We've previously shown you a couple more AllView tablets and this is the latest one of them. It's a 7-inch model and it's very affordable. It only costs $130. It runs Android Jelly Bean. It has a 7-inch display and we're here to show you that this device is pretty interesting in spite of a few problems. But the price is the most affordable bit of it. So as you can see, it's got Android 4.1.1 and this Jelly Bean device actually has a pretty pleasant design. It weighs 327 grams, measures 9.7 millimeters in thickness. It's pretty compact. It has the speaker at the bottom right here. It has this plasticky area for the wireless antenna and it has a main aluminum chassis for the body of the device. And as you can see, as usual with other AllView devices, on this side we got all the ports and slots that matter. So here we got a home button, here we have a reset small hole. Near it there's the micro USB port, the HDMI and the micro SD card slot. On the other side we got the audio jack and the on-off button. And as you can see right here we have a front camera. Other thing worth mentioning is that the device sits well in the user's hand, especially in portrait mode. So there is a predilection for portrait mode rather than landscape. Although when you turn the device on, you'll see that there is a predilection for landscape, since the overall resolution and orientation of icons may seem a bit stretched, but only a bit. Okay, so this aluminum case tablet is called AllView Speed City and we're going to review it right here at tabletnews.com. And now I'm going to refer to the hardware. Okay, so as hardware goes, we got a TFT LCD screen, a capacitive multi-touch display with a 7-inch resolution, with a 7-inch diagonal, excuse me, and a resolution of 800 pixels over 480 pixels. It's got a 16:9 aspect ratio. The OS right here is Android 4.1.1 Jelly Bean, and inside this tablet there's a dual core Cortex A9 1.5 GHz processor, so that powers the device. There's also Mali 400 MP2 GPU that provides solid gaming. We've already tested a couple of games on this tablet and they work just fine. As you can see, we have that trigger installed, we played it and it worked decently. Other things worth mentioning are the 8 GB of internal storage on this device, and we also have available 1 GB of DDR3 RAM, micro SD card slot that's available on this side, and it supports up to 32 GB in extra storage. The tablet is available both in this version, it in both black and white, depending on your preference. And it's got Wi-Fi and it can get 3G if you use a special dongle for that purpose. The front camera, in case you're wondering, is a 0.3 megapixel unit. And this tablet also promises stereo sound and full HD video playback. The battery inside this device is a lithium polymer unit, 3200 mAh. And AllView claims that it should last for about 4 hours of continuous use or 250 hours of standby. In our test, the tablet lasted for 6 hours. Let me show you then a capture of that. So this is the screenshot area and here we are. The tablet lasted for about 6 hours and I have to tell you that during those 6 hours, 1 hour was video playback, 2 hours was gaming, 2 hours was audio playback, and 1 hour was web browsing and standby. So 6 hours of standard use. It will charge from 0% to 100% battery in about 2 hour and a half or maybe 3 hours. Okay, time to test the audio video side of the device in the usual multimedia testing. So I'm going to look for the music player and see what the speakers can do. One thing I must mention, as you can see, we've got virtual volume buttons here, so there are no physical buttons nowhere on this tablet. So let's listen to some Avril Lavigne to test the audio capacity of the tablet. Here we are, loading the song, turning up the volume. The volume is decent, the quality is pretty good, the speaker is here. Let's talk this over.
It's not like we're dead. Was it something I did? Was it something?
It's taking a while to turn to the normal position. And we also have an equalizer available. Sound effects, you can activate them, but you're better off without them. Okay, so now the conclusions. The volume is good, the clarity is good, although the guitar in rock songs will not be heard properly, especially at the maximum volume. Also, if you turn up the maximum volume, the area around the speaker will tend to vibrate just a bit. Overall, it's in good, reasonable, decent limits for a tablet priced at $130. So the audio playback is decent, but not more than that. Okay, now it's time for the video playback to see what the tablet can really do. As you already saw at the start of the review, viewing angles are not that great, but from the side they're a bit more decent, although once again not exactly great. Okay, so let's look for the video player. Here we are, movie player, and let's check out a trailer for GTA 5, the upcoming game from Rockstar. So let's move forward. And moving forward yet again to see some bright colors and action. Viewing angles, as I said, not exactly that bad. The problem is when you do like this. But when you do this, it's reasonably okay. Okay, now time for the conclusions on the video side. The viewing angles are weak, the screen is pretty glossy if you ask me. The tablet is not that bright. Let me tweak up the brightness. I can't really feel the difference between minimum brightness and maximum one. There's not exactly a big difference between these two settings of brightness, and they could have done better. At least the tablet is compatible with Full HD playback, so it easily plays the latest Full HD videos. So on the audio and video side, well, I could say it's mediocre at best, but for $130, that's the best you get. Okay guys, now it's time to compare benchmarks. I decided to compare the benchmarks between this tablet, AllView Speed City, this 7-inch model, and the Samsung Galaxy Tab 2 7.0, since it's double the price of this model. So we're going to compare the screenshots and also include in the mix the Nexus 7, a surprise choice for me, but I thought it was worth mentioning. The benchmarks are actually not that bad, surprisingly. In Quadrant, we scored 4,079 points, while the Galaxy Tab 2 7.0 scores 2,900 points. And surprisingly, the Nexus 7, when we tested it, so many months ago, scored 3,600. So far, this model wins with the best Quadrant score. Okay, moving on to Antutu. Here we are, Antutu, yet another surprise. 10,000 points, while Galaxy Tab 2 scored 5,300 points, and the Nexus 7 scored also 10,000. So we're sitting pretty well in the benchmarks, but now I'm going to move to Nenamark. Here we score 46 frames per second, once again not bad. Galaxy Tab 2 7.0 scored 26 frames per second, and Nexus 7 scored 55, so it ruled. It had a Tegra 3 CPU, here we have a dual core one. Finally, in Velamo, here's the Velamo score we got. Here we are. As you can see, we're sitting on top of the Sony Tablet S with 1,219, while the Galaxy Tab 2 7.0 scored 1,000, and the Nexus 7 scored 1,700. We also tried the browser mark test, but sadly, the performance was not that great. Only 600 points, that is clearly surpassed by the Galaxy Tab and the Nexus 7 and pretty much any device out there. Since we mentioned the browser and browser performance, I'm going to access said browser. Here we are. And now you can also see the virtual keyboard in the divided split version with a numeric keyboard in the middle. And let's try to access Tablet News. Okay, Tablet News, looking for the symbols. Back to the browser again. That's the problem with the virtual buttons. You can always press them by mistake, especially if you have the volume buttons so close near your hand. Here we are, tabletnews.com. It loaded reasonably fast. The page is fully loaded, nothing missing. We're scrolling around without a problem. We're pinching to zoom. So the web browsing experience isn't bad. That's why I'm really puzzled by that low browser mark score. And this is the page viewed in a 4-inch, in a 7-inch portrait format. So the web browser is very well taken care of. Okay, of course you can do some multitasking, as I already showed you, the typical Android multitasking. This is Jelly Bean on board. We've got this expanded notification area. We got your widgets available right here. So typical for Android. What's not typical is the bundled software that you get with this device. If you saw our other reviews for AllView tablets, you know that they come bundled with the Bitdefender antivirus that I frankly have not used since I didn't need it. It's got a malware scanner, application audit, web security, and event viewer. You can run a full scan, and there's a useful anti-theft feature in case you feel threatened by thieves and you want to recover your device after it's been stolen. Let's see what else we have pre-installed on the tablet. Unlike some other cheap tablets, this model actually can access Google Play Store. There were some tablets at some point that were very cheap, but they could not access the Google Play Store. We also got Gmail. Let's see where it is. Here it is, Gmail. And aside from Gmail, we got Google Maps. Let's see where that one went. Here it is, Google Maps. Since they changed the icon, it's pretty hard to find Google Maps with that new icon. It doesn't jump out as much as the old one did. As far as I know, this tablet doesn't have a GPS, so you'll be using what I like to call Wi-Fi triangulation to find your position, but it behaves decently, although you shouldn't try to use it as a GPS on your car. We also got some other bundled applications from AllView. They also bundled an app installer, a PDF viewer that you may find useful. It's nice that you can see the manual of the tablet like a PDF. So instead of distributing a paper manual, you get the PDF version and you can open it with this PDF viewer. We also got Office Suite and a notes application. So you also got the multi-link keyboard, and this is the notes application. They also bundled something called Stunnel. There's a news application, and we also tested a couple of games on this device and they worked just fine. And obviously you can also socialize, so that's why we installed Google Plus. Apparently it shows the older interface, and this is the stream of info with what people are saying. So you can socialize using Google Plus. You can also check out the photos, a view from your albums, from your phone, other stuff like that. And finally you can see your profile. But you can also socialize via Twitter. For this one, I frankly prefer the portrait orientation a bit more. And here you can see the people that mentioned you. Start a new tweet from here. And you can also see the portrait orientation of the keyboard. So that's about everything I had to say about the tablet. As you can see, the lag is not exactly very present, so the functioning is reasonable, all things considered. I mean, considering the $130 price. For the end of the review, I left something juicy for you. As I will do the conclusions, I will also stop some of the apps and prepare the tablet to run a pretty intensive game. It's Dead Trigger. It's a free first-person shooter in the Play Store. It has been highly successful in 2012, and I want to show you that even on a cheap tablet you can run it. And now for the pros and cons of the tablet while I'm playing. The pros is the price, of course, is the obvious $130 price. The resilience of the device, it's got a solid aluminum chassis. And let's enter this mission. Also, the friendly format, you can hold it like this easily in one hand. It's got Jelly Bean pre-installed, it's got no significant lag, the audio is decent, the battery is quite good, the games are working just fine, even some modern ones. Those are the pros. The cons, well, this is how the game looks like. This is the graphics. Sadly, it's a static mission, but you get the idea. So that trigger works just fine on this tablet. Okay, so I'm continuing the list of pros and cons. With the cons, the viewing angles, a bit disappointing. As I said, there are no physical volume buttons that some people may miss. There are poorly placed home button and on-off button. I constantly confuse them. The home button is here, the on-off button is here, and I mix them with one another all the time. Also, the brightness could have been much, much better. The resolution of the screen could have also been better, so it's time for the conclusions. We give this tablet an 8 for design, 7 for hardware, and a 9 for operating system and user interface. The total combined grade is 8 out of 10 for this device, made by AllView. It's called AllView Speed City. It costs $130, so it's cheap, and it's a reasonable buy if you don't want to spend too much dollars. That's it, tabletnews.com out. Bye bye.